My soul longs for you. My soul longs for you. Nothing else will do. Nothing else will do. My soul longs for you. My soul longs for you. Nothing else will do.
Father, we thank you for your blessing upon tonight. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you would inspire us. Holy Spirit, your anointing will be present here tonight. We pray, Holy Spirit, that everything we do and say will bring honor to the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you as you take your seats. All right, I would like us, please, to stand and welcome the Word of Faith Bible Institute graduates of 2016. Amen. They're going to be coming. Let's all stand. Let's applaud them. I want to speak to the Bible students first and foremost, and obviously to the greater congregation as well. A message, just a few scriptures just to speak about. And I first want to read from Philippians chapter 3, from verse 4 to 7. Paul speaking says, though I myself have reason for confidence in the flesh also. If anyone else thinks he has a reason for more confidence in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, a persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless. But whatever gain I had, I counted it as loss for the sake of Christ. What an educated man was Paul. It was then Saul, studied under the best teachers of his day. And he claims that he was a Pharisee, and that he was. And to be a Pharisee, you obviously had to study the first five books of the Old Testament, which we know is the Pentateuch or the Torah. And basically, if you become a senior Pharisee, you've got to be able to quote the first five books of the Bible. Imagine that. You must have had an intelligence capacity to be able to do that. And then we have our classes that we've had for the last 1 to 3 years. And then we give you scripture memory verses, and you guys squealed about it. Not so. It was the hardest part of college, wasn't it? Was to do the scripture memory and write in and pull the scriptures out. This man claimed to be a Pharisee and he had a pedigree. We have not opened a Bible college to give you head knowledge only. Guys, we have got brilliant curriculum, awesome curriculum that's well balanced. But we didn't bring this college so we can fill your people's heads with a lot of knowledge and ultimately release you from this college tonight as a Pharisee. We haven't come here to raise up Pharisees, people that have intelligence and insight into the word, but of no value in the world system. And so we balanced out our Bible college, and Pastor Jimmy makes a comment on our advert. And you can laugh at it and say, he says it's the best college in South Africa. So we say flippantly, that could be a comment just to sound great. But I want to tell you, it's the truth. It's the truth. When I looked at that, I said, this man's not just talking nonsense. He's taking the truth. This is not a sales gimmick. This is the truth. Because out of this college, over the years, have graduated people of God that have touched this world. Not just Pharisees that have head knowledge, but history makers and earth shakers that have shaken the world. Yes, people have come out here and have got great ministries. Some of them are sitting on that platform there that have come out of this college. And I want to see what comes out this year out of this college. I want to see the greatness that has been put inside of you over the last 3 years. And as you continue in your second year, and your second year is going to third year, I want to see you people become people of the Spirit. Not just walking out with a diploma, a degree, and a certificate here tonight to go and frame on a wall. That is basically worthless because you got to go and work it out now and do something for the kingdom and become great. So this same Paul that says he was this prestigious person tells us in Colossians 3 verse 16, he says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. So now you've got to take this word and let it become alive in you and keep it within your spirit. Because you need the word of God. You need the balance of the spirit and the word. And we pumped the word into you. We've had practical. But look what he goes on to say in Ephesians 5 verse 8, and this is what I like. He says, and do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, that be filled with the Spirit. And this is a college of the Spirit, of the Holy Ghost. We are not shy. That is why we're the best college. That is why we can say and stand with Pastor Jimmy and say, this is the best college of Africa. Why? Because this college has gone out into the highways, into the byways of Port Elizabeth, and into the Eastern Cape and beyond, and won over 70,000 souls in the last 3 years. No other college has done that. Guys, this is an exceptional college. This is a college of the Spirit. Tell me a college that goes out into the streets and lays hands on crippled people and they walk. They throw their crutches away. Come on, guys, you've seen it. You've seen it in operation. You've done it. This is a school of the Spirit. We're not going to be Pharisees. We're going to be doers of the word. We're going to go and do and fulfill the Great Commission. Why? Because lastly, as I close, because we need to give Pastor Jimmy as much time as possible because he wants to anoint you guys as well. But it says in Acts 13, verse 8, but Elymas, the magician, opposed them, seeking to turn the proconsul away from the faith. But listen to this. But Saul, who was also called Paul, listen, it says, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked intently at him and said, you son of the devil, you enemy of righteousness, you full of deceit and villainy, will you not stop making crooked paths straight of the Lord? What was he saying? With the anointing of God in his life, with the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost anointing inside of him, he confronted the devil. Listen, your degree is not going to help you at that moment. That thing on the wall there, that beautiful certificate, is not going to cast out devils. It's the Holy Ghost in you. It's the Holy Ghost that we are teaching the people in this college. I want to tell you, if you've got kids that are going into a gap year, send them to Word of Faith Bible Institute. We're going to get them full of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And they're going to be people, not just of word, but there will be city changers that will go out into this city and beyond and do things. When the devil confronts us, we need the Holy Ghost. And because this man transitioned from being a Pharisee into a spirit-filled man of God, no devil in hell could stop him in his mission. And I want to say, when you depart, some of your third years are going on for greater things, and whatever God's got in store for you, stick around second years, you're going to go on to greater things. First years, stay where you are, we're going to move into greater things. Amen? And I want to say to you, when you leave this college, I want to say that you're going to be full of the Holy Ghost like never before. Don't stop doing the good things that you were taught. Don't stop practicing the things that you practiced in Bible college, because now you're going to go into society and change and become salt and light out there. This is my charge to you today. Don't leave this place with a Pharisaical spirit, but leave with the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you. Amen. At this point in time, I want you to welcome and congratulate and thank and pour our heart out towards the president of this college, Dr. Jimmy Crompton. I'd like him just to come forward. We just want to give you a special gift, Pastor Jimmy, just to say in small terms, thank you so much for having this vision and this heart for Bible College, for being faithful to the call, for being obedient to the call, for standing as a man of faith, as I said at the banquet. Thank you so much. Because of you and your vision, people's lives have been transformed. The city, the face of the city has even changed. Souls have got saved. Thank you very much. God bless you.
I want to say thank you for this gift. I didn't expect it. But you students, you my gift. You my blessing.
Good evening, everybody. It is now my pleasure, my privilege to introduce you to the first years of 2016. 1 year certificate. First years, you may stand and take your place. Give them a hand, please. You may take your place. Graduating with magna cum laude, Nomthandaza Boltina. Edward Bueta. Herschel Conradi. Wedeline Cunningham. Graduating with magna cum laude, Fundisa Glula. You Randy Hoffman. Chanel Leeds. Fabian Prinsloo. Graduating cum laude, Geraldine van Eden. Graduating cum laude, Sharon Jonathan. Fernando Kaiser. Nangamzo Ruanka. Graduating summa cum laude, Celicia Liebenberg. Celicia is also the academic student of the year. Fulawa Kupe. Guys, you may be seated. And now we present the second years of 2016 associate's degree. Can you please rise and take your place? Give them a hand as they take their place. Juliet Sonia Chiaruca. Deline Collins. Yes. Madeleine Dreiman. Marilyn Yvonne Ferndale. There's only one Pastor Marilyn. Anita Grimsel. Eric Jeringa. Dormel Keizer. Graduating summa cum laude, Edith Ophelia Cora. Lizanne Lewis. Graduating magna cum laude, Nomfundiso Machociana. Ayrton Mitchley. Novesutu Cynthia Ndika. Nomandla Marion Inkazana. Kathleen Sharon Vina. Well done, second years. You may be seated. Now we present to you the third years of 2016, Bachelor of Ministry degree. You may rise. This is, of course, their final year, Bachelor of Ministry degree. You may take your place. And graduating summa cum laude, Tembisa Benmoazi. Graduating magna cum laude, Shanaz Brooks. Graduating magna cum laude, Esther M. Fransman. Graduating magna cum laude, Bernard Klein. Graduating cum laude, Sekai Anna Kudiacheti. Stephen Lyons. Justinadio Maxius Frencholonadade Mathis. I think I just graduated magna cum laude after that name. Graduating cum laude, Wala Chingai Muranganwa. Graduating summa cum laude, Nomonde Nhloko. graduating magna cum laude, Joel Oberholzer. Anthony Opoku. Graduating magna cum laude, Janita Potgieter. Natasha Jillian Prinsloo. Jonathan Lee van die Kerk. And then last, but not least, one of our students that would have graduated tonight has gone to be with the Lord this year. He's received the ultimate promotion. Siabulelo Chielo. We'd just like to know if Sia's brother is in the house or any of his family here, so they can receive his certificate posthumously. Okay, that's fine. We're going to hand deliver to his mom. Ladies and gentlemen, a final hand clap for our graduates of 2016.
I just want to say that, you know what's outstanding about this? There's young people over there that have just graduated. Either one girl got the highest marks, the best, she, what do they call it? You got all these technical names for the summa cum laude. She won it. When she came to our Bible school, she couldn't study. She now is writing exams and getting straight A's. There's other people like that, and there's young people that came in, we nearly kicked them out of the Bible school, now they've graduated 2 years, and believe it or not, they're going to have a Bachelor of Divinity degree in a year's time if the Lord tarries. That's what this Bible school is all about. Amen. All right. I want you all to listen, but especially your third years, because I have a word from the Lord for you. It's found in the 6th chapter. The 6th chapter of the book Isaiah. And you must forgive me, my little grandson of 11 graduated with a growth point. I was very proud of him. Amen. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1. It was in the year that King Uzziah died that I saw the Lord. He was sitting in a lofty throne, and the train of his robe. You know, when a woman gets married and these rich, like Princess Di, I remember she had a train. That is the thing that the bridesmaids carry behind her. The train of his robe filled the temple. Attending him were mighty seraphim, each having six wings, two wings. They covered their face, two covered their feet, two with two they flew. They were called out. They were calling out to each other, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of heaven's armies. The whole earth is filled with his glory." Their voices shook the temple to its foundations, and the entire building was filled with smoke. Then I said, "It's all over. I'm doomed. For I'm a sinful man. I have filthy lips, and I live among a people with filthy lips. Yet I've seen the King, the Lord of heaven's armies." Then one of the seraphim flew to me with a burning coal it had taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. He touched the lips with it and said, "See, this gold has touched your lips. Now your guilt is removed and your sins are forgiven." Then I heard the Lord asking, "Whom shall I send as a messenger to these people? Who will go for us?" And I said, "Here I am. Send me." It's already been said a few times. This Bible school is not just about education in the secular sense of the word, although we teach very solidly the word of God. But there's some interesting facts. When the prophet saw the Lord was when King Uzziah died. When King Uzziah died, there was nobody in the throne. And then he saw the one that is the true king. Students, and everybody else here, obviously I speak to them, but it pertains to us all. You have to have only one king, and his name is Jesus. And when you read this, the seraphims were majestic beings that when they called to one another, the very temple building shook. Can you imagine if angels called and this building began to tremble? And this massive temple, bigger than this, began to tremble because of the, and they said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God." I want you to know, it's very interesting, listen to me, that in the year that King Uzziah died, Romulus, who started the city of Rome, was born that same year. The king, the last king, fell away out of Israel, and the starter of the biggest world dominion, the Roman Empire, was born. There was the one, the king that should have been the leader, should have been God's man, died, and the devil's crowd were born. And I want you to know tonight that we're living in those days. And the question now comes, and he says, "I'm doomed. I've seen the Lord. I've seen his glory." I pray, God, that you in your Bible school in the two or three years you've been here, that to some extent, to some way, you've seen the glory of the Lord. But when you see the glory of God, church, you know what you do? You say, "Woe is me, I'm doomed." Because next to God, we are so poor, broken, sinful. But the blood of Jesus Christ, note that the angel took the coal from the altar. You know where the altar was? Where the sacrifice shed its blood and paid the price. And from that altar, tonight I am praying. I'm praying speaking specifically to third years. I want God to take a coal from the altar of Calvary and put it on your lips and say, "You are cleansed, you are forgiven, you are made right in my sight, says the Lord, that you may go out and do exploits, raise the dead and heal the sick and win many, many more thousands of souls for Jesus Christ." Say, "Put the coal on his lips." And then the Lord says, yes, something very interesting. You want to study in the, be in the Bible, study. The Bible says, and the Lord said, and I said, the Lord said, singular. Who will go for us? Plural. It's like me saying to myself, who will go for us? I'm not a us. But you know what? Do you know what they were crying day and night? Holy, holy, holy. You know the us's, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Lord is one Lord, three persons in the Trinity, and He, the Trinity, is calling you out and saying, who will go for us? There's a lost world out there. There's people that are dying in sin. Don't go through 3 years and get blessed and be made whole in your emotions and what have you, and just go out and live a good life. God is saying to you and to this whole church, who will go for me? Who shall I send? And who will go for me? And I believe these men and women have gone to the Bible school because they've said, Lord, here am I. Send me. Amen. I want the third years all to come up on the platform, please. I wondered about tonight. I wanted to get the international head year, but it seems like his program is so heavy that it was difficult to get him. And then we tried two other pastors, and they graduating their Bible schools tonight at the same time, so they couldn't come. And then the Lord spoke to me and said, you know what? You've got the anointing of God. By the way, for those who don't know, Sunday morning we're having a special meeting to commemorate the life of one of the sons of this house, Kim Clement. I found him selling keyboards on Main Street, Port Elizabeth. Called him in the ministry that very same day that I met him. And he went on to prophesy to the President of the United States. Had personal meetings with the President of the United States. God picked him up. He was lying in the gutter. He was lying in the gutter full of drugs and alcohol when an Anglican priest picked him up and took him up and washed him and cleaned him, and he got saved, and he became my first youth pastor, my first music director, and he ministered, as I've just said, he ministered to the President, at that time, the only world power. So he was the highest man in the earth. And this young man from our church prophesied over that man, was invited by the President. He didn't go to the President. You don't just don't go to the President. The President invited him. Then Rodney Out Brown had his first ever campaign in our church. And Rodney has shaken nations for God. And there's Denver Marks, who was in our Bible school, that is impacting Tanzania for God. And I could go on and on and on. And so the Lord said, don't ask for somebody else. I called you to start this Bible school. I want you to lay hands on these people. And so I say to you standing here, look at me, please. The Bible says, who will, God, the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost says, who will go for me? I command you that you should continue to work for the Lord. God has called you, and it's time for you to set out on a mission for God. We certainly need you here in Word of Faith. But if God takes you further, God bless you. That's so long as you go for God. Amen. Hallelujah. You know what the meaning of the Greek word for anointing is? To rub, to smear it in. Amen. Anoint you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Anoint you. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, anoint you. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. I'm scriptural. I'm rubbing it in. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, hallelujah. In Jesus' name. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. I just need to. I've got that. Hallelujah. I need. Come on, boys. What? Wake up. Come on. Father, I speak to this pastor. Let the Holy Ghost fill his heart, his mind, and his future with joy and power and anointing of God. Oh, Lord, let it come. Hallelujah. Bless my PA, Lord. Make her a blessing to this church as she serves me. Let the anointing of God rest upon her. Lord, thank you for the blessing that Monday has been the Bible school. Let her continue to bless this church and this city. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let him go, man. In the name of Jesus, I commission you to the work of the ministry. I commission you to the anointing of the Holy Ghost. You blow that trumpet until people get healed and people get saved. I commission you, daughter of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let that church multiply, Lord. Karababashanamahanda. Karababa Rabahanda, hallelujah. Come on, Karababanda Rabashana. In the name of Jesus, make this woman a mighty evangelist. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore. Raise your hands and sing it one more time. Come on, we've come here to glorify the Lord. Fill this place with your glory. Come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Christ the Lord. Now, I want to encourage you to sign on for this Bible school. These people, those guys there and these people, they went into one village outside of Ntata and they won half the village for the Lord. They had a breakout revival that the whole village was touched and changed. They prayed for blind people, stone blind, and they received their sight. Deaf ears opened. People threw their crutches away. Miracles, 70,000 souls in the streets. Give the Lord a hand. Come on.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. Guys, there's one more thing we need to do, and that is I need to present to you the class of 2014, 2015, and 2016. Well done. Congratulations to you all. Let's give them a hand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Congratulations. Come on. Let's give them a hand.
Where you go, I go. What you say, I say. What you pray, I pray. What you pray, I pray. Where you go, I go. What you say, I say. What you pray, I pray. What you pray, I pray.